Marijuana has been used since the early 1900s, like any other herbs, such as chamomile or green tea leaves. Now, medical marijuana is legal in 23 states for the medical use. It is used to help cure symptoms of serious diseases such as AIDS, cancer, epilepsy, and glaucoma. It is completely legal in only one state, which is Colorado, as Anna mentioned. People that are hurting and physically in pain go there to use marijuana, such as a late family friend of mine that had neurofibrosis sarcoma, which is cancer in your nerves. She was going there to live out her end and didn't want to live it out painfully. Now, she didn't just go there to get a cheap high before she died. She used this as a medical reliever, as many other cancer patients did. The one setback with the medical usage is when patients are taken off or weaned off their dosages, they go out to buy their own laced marijuana, which can cause seizures and other complications. Now, making that legal, we can set restrictions on pure marijuana that is good and doesn't make seizures happen in patients that have those diseases, so they won't go out and do that. And because when they go out and do that on the THC that's laced within that medical marijuana, then they get arrested for possession of it. Now, that should be categorized under a 5150, which is a psychological arrest. They would scan over the person, see what caused this, and then based on what the jury decides, they would either stay in prison for what they did or they would get psychological help. And that's what should be done by making it legal. Now, when Julia mentioned that college students with bad grades have been linked to marijuana, that's not all true. Patients that use marijuana that are in college may happen to have bad grades because of those diseases that set them back, such as ADHD. Some kids are cured with that medical marijuana. But when you make that legal, in Colorado, when you're 21 or older, you can get 1 ounce a day, and that's a restriction on it. If you take it anywhere outside the borders, you get arrested because of that. By making it nationally legal, we can have it legal everywhere for 1 ounce a day to help those people with that, and it wouldn't cause any bad grades. Yes?
Well, if it's legal, wouldn't it be easier to get more than 1 ounce a day?
No, because they have restrictions on it. That's what I'm trying to say. The state would control the restrictions on it. So you would only get 1 ounce a day. You would go to the store one time a day, and it would be pure marijuana. It wouldn't cause any other complications because it wouldn't have any other drugs within it. It's pure, and it helps. It's scientifically proven. That's all.
There are lots of different consequences and effects for marijuana. The two big or main groups of marijuana effects are long and short-term effects. The long-term effects impact us the most, but the short-term effects can still impact us greatly. The short-term effects are sensory distortion, panic, anxiety, poor coordination of movement, lower reaction time, and increased heartbeat. Poor coordination of movement, sensory distortion, and lower reaction time could cause your death if you are driving.
That's because they're using the marijuana that isn't pure, that has THC, that causes all those symptoms.
You could crash or be hit. Also, you could get a panic attack from panic anxiety. Another short-term effect is poor memory and ability to learn. If you have poor memory, you could forget where your car was or where you live. Then you would be lost for a pretty long time, and you could get in trouble if it ends up bad. This could also cause you to forget what your parents taught you was bad. And you could go steal something from...
What was bad in the past could be a new good, because medical stuff is improving in the future today. So by making this marijuana clean and pure, that could be the new good, which used to be bad.
I know, but, like, marijuana, it could cause you to do something bad, like, that is still bad, like, maybe...
By state regulation and the proper dosage and not going over that, and only going to the store once a day, it would help. Would help that, and it would restrict them from going anywhere over to the point where they would cause accidents and actually killing someone in a car accident.
The long-term effects are reduced resistance to common illnesses, suppression of the immune system, growth disorders, increase of abnormally structured cells in the body, reduction of male sex hormones, study difficulties, reduced ability to learn and retain information, apathy, drowsiness, lack of motivation, personality and mood changes, inability to understand things clearly, and risk of heart attack. Taking marijuana would get you sick more often than normal, and it would be harder for you to concentrate on work and pay attention in class. No one really likes to be sick except for the people that get sick just to skip school. And as usual, getting sick is bad for your health. This would cause you to get in trouble in school and at work, wherever you are at. Another long-term effect is lung cancer. If you are taking marijuana frequently over time, you can develop lung cancer at this moment. There are lots of different ways and reasons to get cancer, but I think the worst way is to get it by your own mistakes. You will be regretting that for the rest of your life, and you might not forgive yourself. Don't think that just because you took a small dose that nothing will happen. All of this could possibly happen. A small dose would probably just reduce the effect. Having marijuana legalized would change the world forever, and probably in a bad way. Also, when people take a drug, they start to get addicted to it, not this time, and just keep taking more and more of it, which starts to cause major effects. This can corrupt our country and maybe eventually the world.